Good morning to all of you, respected principal sir, VMC members, parents, and my dear students. Today, on the occasion of National Sports Day celebration, myself, A. Adhikari, TGTPHNE of KV number 1, Ichhapur, want to say a few words on the renowned hockey player Major Dhyanchand. Students, I will be speaking both in English as well as in Hindi for the small children so that they can also easily understand the things what I am speaking. When we are thinking of a magician in the Indian hockey, one name come to our mind. It is Major Dhyanchand, who was born in the year 1905 on 29th August. And 29th August, every year, Government of India as well as KVS are celebrating National Sports Day. Dear students, as you know, in this pandemic, the importance of fitness plays a very important role to be a healthy person. KVS also trying to involve students as well as their parents to do few fitness exercises every day. It may be in the morning or in the evening. KVS is also conducting Fit India Run, which has been started from 15th August and it will be going up to 2nd October. Our students are also participating in it and we are happy that this message of to be fit is going to the children. Now, coming to Major Dhyanchand, he was educated from Maharani Lakshmibai Government College and he was awarded Padma Bhushan in the year 1956. As you know, he was the person who helped India to win 3 gold medals in the year 1928, 1932 and 1936. Dhyanchand was called magician because of his hockey skill as well as his control over the ball. In his international career, he has scored more than 400 goals. So, Government of India this year only has changed Rajiv Gandhi Khel Award to Major Dhyanchand Khel Award. And one more thing, that after 1980, this was the first time both Indian men's and women's team done very good in the Tokyo Olympic. The boys team won the bronze medal and the girls team got the fourth position. It is a great achievement for 135 crores of Indian that after 1980, this feat was achieved. It is the hard work of the players, the help of the government, as well as the supporting staff. The Odisha government, who sponsored this team for 10 years, also helped the players to do well in the Tokyo Olympic. We want the students of our institution also to come up in various sports and do well in various fields. When we are talking of Major Dhyanchand, there are a few interesting facts about Major Dhyanchand. कुछ जो इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट्स हैं मेजर ध्यानचंद के बारे में वो मैं आपके सामने रखना चाहता हूँ. मैं हिंदी में बोल रहा हूँ ताकि हमारे स्कूल के जो छोटे बच्चे हैं उनको भी समझ में आ जाए. पहला चीज, ध्यानचंद का नाम ध्यान सिंह था. चांद जो नाम है या चंद जिसका नाम है वो इसलिए उनको दिया गया उनके दोस्तों द्वारा, उनके फेलो प्लेयर्स के द्वारा, क्योंकि वो रात में भी जाके प्रैक्टिस करते थे. दूसरा एक एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी थिंग इस आदमी में था, एक बार वो मैच खेल रहे थे, वो एक भी गोल स्कोर नहीं कर पा रहे थे, लेकिन उनको इंटरवल में डाउट हुआ, वो मैच रेफरी के पास गए और कंप्लेन किया कि गोल का साइज थोड़ा छोटा होगा. जब मैच रेफरी ने इंटरवल में वो मेजर किया, उनको सरप्राइज हुआ जे वो गोल का साइज थोड़ा छोटा था. इससे ये पता चल रहा है उस इंसान में कितनी एक्यूरेसी थी. तीसरा है, जब 1936 के बर्लिन ओलंपिक में पोस्टर लगाया गया जर्मनी में जे अगर आपको कोई मैजिशियन हॉकी का देखना है आप जरूर ग्राउंड में जाइए, और उन्होंने निराश नहीं किया, उन्होंने इतना अच्छा खेल दिखाया कि वहां के जो हिटलर थे उन्होंने उनको बुलाया और उनको ऑफर दिया कि वो जर्मनी का कोई कर्नल का पोस्ट लें, लेकिन उन्होंने मुस्कुराते हुए कहा मेरा भारत सबसे अच्छा है. एक बार जब वो नीदरलैंड में खेलने गए, वहां के अथॉरिटीज ने उसको डाउट हुआ क्या उनके हॉकी स्टिक में कोई मैग्नेट तो नहीं लगा हुआ है, इसलिए उन्होंने उनका हॉकी स्टिक चेक किया, उनको तोड़ा गया, फिर उसका चेक किया गया, फिर भी वो पता चला कि उसमें ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं. एक बार जब वो ऑस्ट्रेलिया में गए थे, उन्होंने जब डॉन ब्रैडमैन से मिले थे तो जॉन ब्रैडमैन ने यह बोला था जे मैं जितना रन स्कोर करता हूँ उसी तरह आप तो हॉकी में गोल स्कोर करते हैं. ये इंसान मेजर ध्यानचंद को अपनी एक ऑटो बायोग्राफी में, उनको जो ऑटोबायोग्राफी था उनका नाम था गोल, जो पब्लिश हुआ 1952 में. मैं यही बोलना चाहता हूँ बच्चों, अगर आप में लगन है, आप में कोशिश है, तो जरूर आप लाइफ में सक्सेस होंगे. इस पैंडेमिक में आप लोग, योर पेरेंट्स शुड इन्वॉल्व इन योरसेल्फ इन फ्यू फिजिकल एक्टिविटी और एक्सरसाइजेस व्हिच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन लाइफ. एज आई हैव टोल्ड अर्लियर, इट विल बी हेल्पिंग यू इन द नियर फ्यूचर. थैंक यू. जय हिंद.
Dear students, their parents and their teachers, once again I am here to remind you about the importance of good health. Last year when I talked about good health, the virus was threatening us. Even today, the battle is not over. We are being threatened by the same virus. In between these days, we have lost many of our near and dear ones. because they were not able to fight the challenge. They were not able to take up the virus as their enemy and fight with that. The struggle for existence has begun. And those who are not fit will perish. This is what the rule of nature is. But if you are physically fit, you can fight all battles. Let it be a mental battle, let it be a psychological battle, let it be a social battle, whatever it is. A healthy body can fight any battle. Because a healthy body carries a healthy mind. And if you have a healthy mind and healthy body, the world is yours. So, we'll have to try to keep ourselves physically fit. So that we can be of some use to the society. We can be of some use to the humanity as a whole. What should we do? We should do exercises regularly. Light exercises. We can go to the field for jogging. We can take to yoga. Secondly, we need to eat healthy food. And we need to keep ourselves away from all negative thoughts. These are the few things that we need to do. And that will keep us perfectly fit. Today, because of online classes, we are not able to think of the outdoor activities, outdoor games. Because of the lockdown imposed on us, we are not able to get out freely. But in spite of that, we need to keep ourselves fit. How to do that? Go for exercise at home. Take good food, home prepared food. Avoid junk food. So you'll find yourself fit. Now, if you are going to study, there also you need a good health. Otherwise, nothing will be retained. Otherwise, even if you retain so many things in your mind, you won't be able to warm it out. So whenever you are challenged, you need to have a good health to fight the challenge. Let it be academic challenge, let it be physical challenge, let it be mental challenge, let it be social challenge. Any challenge, if you want to fight, you need to have a good health. So I would like to request the parents also to prioritize good health, even over academics. So those children who enjoy good health will be able to do good in their academics also. So students and parents both are requested to take measures to enjoy good health, to keep good health. So that when you come back to the school, after the school reopens, we find you in good health. And we can plan to win over everything, to win the world. That's our dream is. Don't forget. Thank you.
Hello, I am Shreshi Palodhi, student of KV number 1, Ishapur. First of all, thank you for giving me an opportunity to speak on COVID-19 fitness at home, a feedback. The World Health Organization, WHO, has declared the coronavirus disease as a pandemic or COVID-19. On 31st December 2019, a cluster of cases of pneumonia of unknown cause in the city of Yuan, Hubei in the China was reported to the World Health Organization. In January 2020, a previously unknown new virus was identified, subsequently named the coronavirus novel 2019. This novel coronavirus was named as coronavirus disease or COVID-19 by WHO, World Health Organization, in February 2020. This virus is referred to as SARS-CoV-2 and the associated disease is COVID-19. In COVID-19, the lungs are mostly affected. The COVID-19 pandemic means that many of us are staying at home and sitting down more than we usually do. It's hard a lot of us to do the sort of exercises we normally do. It's even harder for people who don't usually do a lot of physical exercise. But at times like this, it's a very important for people like ages, old ages and abilities to be as active as possible. WHO's Be Active campaign aims to help us to do just that and to have some fun at the same time. Like, just take a short break from sitting by doing 3 to 4 minutes of light intensity physical movement, such as walking or stretching or doing exercises, will help ease your muscles and improve blood circulation and muscle activity. Regular physical activity benefits both the mind and body. It can reduce high blood pressure, help manage weight, and reduce the risk of heart disease, stroke, type 2 diabetes, and various cancers. All that conditions that can increase susceptibility of COVID-19. It also improves bones and muscle strength and increase balance, flexibility, and fitness. For older people, activities that improve balance help to prevent falls and injuries. Regular physical activity can help to give our day a routine and be a way to stay in contact with friends and families. It's also good for our mental health, reducing the risk of depression, cognitive decline and delay on the onset of dementia, and improve overall feelings. So, here goes a question. What is the importance of exercise during COVID-19? While on lockdown, physical activities needs to be maintained as it is extremely beneficial to body and mind. It is important for controlling diabetes and high blood pressures, maintaining both strength and muscle tone through exercise, which is important especially as the regular outdoor activity is curtailed during the COVID-19 pandemic. Exercise also helps boost immunity, reduces the risk of mental health and overall depressions. You can walk for short periods such as 10 minutes at a time, or practice yoga routines or interval training depending on your age, pre-existing health conditions and doctor's advice. So I prefer to recommend you that please do exercise, yoga, pranayama, etc. at morning for both adult and children to stay healthy and fit. Thank you.
मैं वीर सिंह, डिप्टी कमांडेंट CISF, अर्जुन पुरस्कार से सम्मानित कुश्ती का अंतर्राष्ट्रीय खिलाड़ी हूँ। आज राष्ट्रीय खेल दिवस के उपलक्ष्य में आप लोगों से जुड़कर मुझे बड़ा हर्ष हो रहा है, और मैं केंद्रीय विद्यालय के छात्रों, शिक्षकों व अभिभावकों का आभार व्यक्त करता हूं और धन्यवाद देता हूं कि आज आपके साथ जुड़ने का मुझे मौका मिला। मैं सभी को कहना चाहूँगा कि पढ़ाई लिखाई के साथ साथ खेल कूद भी बहुत ज़रूरी है, और आज के युग में खेल कूद से हम बहुत आगे तक जा सकते हैं। आज राष्ट्रीय खेल दिवस मेजर ध्यानचंद जी के जन्मदिवस के उपलक्ष्य में मनाया जाता है। मेजर ध्यानचंद जी को सभी जानते हैं कि हॉकी का जादूगर कहते थे। मैं सभी अभिभावकों से नम्र निवेदन करना चाहता हूं कि वो अपने बच्चों को खेल के क्षेत्र में जो है प्रोत्साहित करें, क्योंकि आज खेल का क्षेत्र एक ऐसा क्षेत्र बन गया है कि जिसमें मान सम्मान सभी कुछ इसमें मिलता है, चाहे सरकारी नौकरी हो, चाहे पैसा हो, चाहे इज्जत हो, चाहे देश का नाम ऊंचा करने का जज्बा हो, सभी कुछ इसके द्वारा हासिल होता है। और जो खेल के क्षेत्र में जो है शारीरिक और मानसिक रूप से जो है फिट होता है, वो पढ़ाई के क्षेत्र में भी आगे बढ़ता है। इसलिए मैं चाहूँगा कि हमारे सभी बच्चे पढ़ाई के साथ साथ खेल के क्षेत्र में भी रुचि रखें, और जो बच्चे खेल के क्षेत्र में आगे बढ़ते हैं उनका भविष्य बहुत ही उज्जवल होता है। जैसे अभी ओलंपिक से हमारे खिलाड़ियों ने पदक प्राप्त किए हैं, तो राज्य सरकारें, केंद्र सरकार, अन्य एजेंसियां उनको मान सम्मान के तौर पर बहुत कुछ गाड़ियां, बंगले, प्लाट, पैसा सभी कुछ दे रहे हैं। तो इसलिए इसमें भविष्य बहुत अच्छा है। मैं दोबारा से अनुरोध करूंगा कि आज इस खेल दिवस के उपलक्ष्य में मेजर ध्यानचंद जी के जन्मदिन पर यह प्रतिज्ञा लें कि हम भी अपने बच्चों को खेल के क्षेत्र में आगे बढ़ाएंगे और देश का नाम ऊंचा करने में हम पूरा सहयोग और योगदान देंगे। एक बार मैं फिर सादर अनुरोध करता हूं कि मेजर ध्यानचंद जी के जीवन को अपना आदर्श मानकर उसी तरह से जिस तरह से मेजर ध्यानचंद समर्पित हो गए, जो है हॉकी के एक जादूगर के रूप में हॉकी खेलते थे, उसी तरह से अपना एक अलग अलग खेल चुनकर और उस खेल में महारत हासिल कर अपने समाज का, देश का, माँ बाप का और प्रदेश का और देश का नाम जो विदेशों में ऊंचा करें। इसी के साथ, इसी उम्मीद के साथ मैं आप लोगों का एक बार फिर तहे दिल से धन्यवाद करता हूं कि आप लोगों से जुड़ने का मौका मिला। जय हिंद, जय भारत।